Say hey, Yellow Jacket football fans, welcome to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Coach, you got this overtime thing down pretty well. Congratulations.
Thanks, Dave. And I'm not really liking it a whole lot, you know, but I like it because we're winning.
Yeah, that's
it was a very difficult game, so to speak. Offensively, we sputtered a little bit, didn't make plays when we needed to make them, but I can't say enough about the defense.
Yes.
You know, I think Hardman had 35 carries for 140-something yards, and, you know, you're talking about one of the top athletes in the nation, and, you know, if he touches it 35 times, you know, I know Elbert's thinking that, you know, he's gonna break one or two or three or four, and we let him loose one time, and that was it.
I thought the black shirt defensive coach, George Hoplazel Hobb the Elder, was fantastic. I love the way the defensive ends, Blaine Anderson and Landon Rice, pinched down. I cannot remember two games in a row where Landon Rice has played better in his career.
Landon, you know, we watched a little bit of the game last night before we left, and I tell you, our defensive front was amazing the first quarter. I mean, I thought they played extremely well. And the entire game, I hadn't watched the entire game yet, but defensively, I thought we were really good, you know, to hold them to 13 points in,
yes,
in a regular season game, and I mean, a regulation game, and, you know, I thought we were excellent on that side of the ball.
That's okay.
Yeah,
the last two weeks, it feels like we've played a season in two
yeah.
games. The rotation of Drew McIntyre and Austin Stout at nose guard, Jira Wilson said it nicely, the front just allowed him to make plays, and our three guys up front did an outstanding effort. And as you said, when Hardman gets that many touches on the ball, Elbert County thinks they're going to score 40 or 50 points.
Yeah, you know, I can't say enough about the way our kids handled him. You
yes.
know, we were careful because, you know, they had some other backs that can hurt you, and we didn't want to put all the emphasis on Hardman because those other backs can beat you. But I thought our kids read their keys well and played really, really good defense. And, you know, we're beat up with Malik going out, so we had to move Balin corner. You know, Balin hadn't practiced all week. He's beat up. Dusty Baker comes in there and does a great job at Rover. And I thought our linebackers, Jyron and Christian and Noah, really showed up and played extremely well.
I thought Red Abernathy did a nice job on a couple tackles out in the open field. I thought Jordan Tao was fantastic. He had a huge tackle for a loss. I don't know of anybody on the defensive side of the ball that didn't play well.
No, I don't either. I think, you know, our defensive front was really, really physical.
And, yes.
You know, we don't like playing Drew and Austin in there at nose guard, but because of our injury situation and, you know, with CJ being hurt, we hope to get him back a little bit this week. But, you know, what can you say about Drew and Austin
right.
They're playing as much as they're playing at 85 pounds? Says a lot about their character and their stamina, really.
I walked up to Drew after the game, and he just came up and gave me a hug. I thought he was going to collapse into my arms, and there's no way I could hold him up.
No.
Yeah. The offense did everything that they needed to get the victory. And Kalen Riley had a pretty special game with four TDs.
Yeah, Kalen continues to play well for us. You know, we put the ball in his hands in
yes.
the overtimes, and he made plays. You know, early in the game, it's just we've got to find a way to fix what's going on offensively. You know, the first quarter, second quarter, we're moving the ball up and down the field, and then when we get to the 20-yard line or 15-yard line, we stall. And I knew when we had to kick field goals early that it was going to come back to haunt us. You know, we get two touchdowns right there, and I think it'll be a much easier game. It should have been 14-0 early, and I don't really think Elbert would have recovered from that. But them holding us to field goals, and it's just 6-0, it gives them life. And then, you know, we had a few drops that, you know, we overthrew one long pass for a touchdown. We had another drop for a touchdown.
Right.
We just got to make plays, and we're not doing that offensively.
The offense, the pound and shoot offense, has sputtered a little bit as far as making those big plays. Give credit to the opposing teams, Peach County last week and Elbert County this week. Robbie's Raiders were open in holes. You know, Jack DeFore, Blake Garland, William Long, Drew McIntyre, Austin Stout, our tight ends, Landon Rice and Jyra Wilson, just doing a good job of getting things done. And give credit to Elbert County. Their defense bent, didn't break.
Yeah, you know, it seems like we play better when we have to play good. You know, when we're behind and we've got to make plays and we've got to score, it seems like we play better that way offensively. But, you know, we're going to have to take advantage of every opportunity we get, you know, going forward next week for sure. And, you know, we've got to get better offensively. You know, we're not playing bad. You know, we had over 300 yards offense last night against a good Elbert defense, and we just got to get the ball in the end zone.
I like the new formation.
Yeah, we're going to expand on that, I think. You know, we didn't have many plays out of it last night. We put it in for some short yardage situations, but it really worked out well for us.
It worked out well wherever you were on the field, so it did a good job. I'm not going to ask you to be specific, but this is the time of the year. We're banged up.
Yeah, we are. You know, everybody is banged up this time of year.
Yes.
We're going to have to piece together some people and put our heads together and figure something out. But, you know, with Malik going down, he'll be highly questionable for next week. So that hurts us. But, you know, I think Blessed Trinity's beat up too. I think they've got a lot of injuries. And this time of year, everybody's going to have injuries. And our kids are sore. You know, we're going on game 14, and we're going to have to find a way to get them some rest this week and still get ready for Blessed Trinity.
Probably the two most important people on your staff are Dr. Mitch Frex and trainer Joe Ogden this week.
Yeah, you know, like I said last week, and to be honest, Jira didn't practice all week. He was half speed all week. Balin didn't practice all week. He was, you know, less than half speed. And both those guys came in and played well. Jira was exceptional. And, you know, now with Malik's injury, we're gonna have to find some kind of solution to our injuries. But, you know, we got kids can step up, got to make plays, and got to get lined up and make plays when they need to make them.
We made a lot of plays last night, and we really made the plays at the key time, the crunch time, to get another victory. This one, a triple overtime, 33-30 victory over Elbert County. We're going to take a timeout. We're going to come back and look at those first half highlights. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And Coach, it was just playoff atmosphere. Big crowd on both sides of the bleachers. There were fans from all over Northwest Georgia. And Elbert County brought a bunch of people, and of course our side was packed. I thought our 12th man was quite effective last night.
Yeah, I thought our crowd was tremendous last night. You know, it was just like they always are this time of year, to be honest with you. And, you know, you couldn't ask for better weather. It kind of felt like August, to be honest with you. It was kind of perfect weather. It, you know, started out hot all day today, Friday, and then it cooled off just a little bit.
Chandler Padgett did the national anthem, and again, a Calhoun student or students performs an exquisite rendition of the national anthem, and he was fantastic.
Well, good.
Yeah, I know you don't get to see him, but he was, as I said, after he got done singing, if we finished this game, and we did, like he finished the national anthem, wow, it was good. Captains for tonight's game are?
We got Jarrett Carden, Christian East, Jack D. Ford, and Kalen Riley. We were going to take the ball.
Were you really?
Yep. We felt like they weren't very good in the kickoff game, so we felt like we would have gotten good field position. But I was really surprised. I guess they wanted to toss and took the ball.
Right. Yeah, they took the ball. We're going to kick off. And with another Friday, I can't read. Thank you. Thankful for and blessed for another Friday. There you go. Coach Long helping me out. Oh, there it is. Now it's straightened out. Yeah. Beautiful night. Hardly any breeze at all. 60 degrees at game time. And as you said, it was up in the low 70s. And earlier in the day, and the Yellow Jackets hit the field in their all black uniforms. The good guys are wearing black one more time. We kick off when sky kicks to keep it away from Hardman, right?
Yeah, we sky kick it. You know, it wasn't bad. We'd like to have it inside the 30 if we can get it. But, you know, 36-yard line wasn't terrible.
Well, he gets a 6-yard return. You're happy with that?
Yep.
Yeah. All right, so they line up, and the first thing they do is they don't put Hardman at quarterback. They put him out here at wide receiver and put their backup quarterback there, but they're going to make the change back.
Yeah, I didn't, you know, I didn't understand what they were doing there. They tried to trick us, and I'm certainly glad they didn't throw it out here to him for sure.
Landon Rice with an initial hit right there, and this is just going to be one of many for the evening. That's Jordan Talon on the tackle also.
We got him behind the sticks early.
Yes.
And this is what we wanted him to do. We wanted him to throw the ball, and lo and behold, he makes a great throw and a great catch on our sideline.
Yeah, that might have been one of his better throws all year.
Yeah.
Fortunately for us, it comes up, and I mean, an inch and a half short.
How many times did that happen in the game? Either short or got it by, you know, 6 inches.
Well, we won't talk about what the sideline judge did later in the game. They rolled the first snap back, and I was hopeful that was going to be a future thing for them. This punter had a decent night punting, but it was all on bad punts. It rolled well.
Yeah, so we got it at, 16-yard line.
Yes.
We come out of the gate, throw in a little sideline route here to Dusty Baker. Good throw, good catch. Get it down. Great job on the first play of the game. Get it to the 40.
Yeah, first and 10 for the Jackets. Nice little route there. Kalen hitting right on the button. And then nice push here. We get about a 3-yard gain.
You know, we get in a bad habit of thinking we've got to score every time we run an offensive play.
And, right.
You know, we've got to be patient and settle for a 4 or 5-yard gain.
Nice little bubble screen out here on the left-hand side. Big conversion. We're across midfield, and that is Colby Reynolds with the ball, wearing Ethan Woodard's number tonight. And you're going to see this play a lot throughout the night, folks. Kalen Riley going off right tackle behind Robbie's Raiders. Robbie's Raiders got a good push all night against this 4-man front.
We let one slide through there, but a good run by Aliko making something positive that could have been a negative play.
Number 92, number 32, and number 78 are big defensive linemen.
Third down and one.
Yeah, no longer.
Good job by Aliko lowering his head and getting positive yards.
Well, he got a first down for us. We're at the 29. Aliko ended up with right around 100 yards rushing. Like one thing I saw had 99. That's a long pass across the field, and they're pretty quick.
Yeah, Hardeman came in late, and we just whiffed it. You know, we had everybody blocked up, and we just whiffed the block.
Yeah. Throw it out here on the right-hand side, and once again, we get Colby Reynolds. We've got the ball back at the 30-yard line.
Third and 11.
Yes.
And again, we were pretty good on third down conversion, especially right here. It was a great catch by Malik Lawrence for a first down.
I thought it was a really good route, and then Kalen threw the ball as he was breaking back to the ball. First and 10 for the Jackets. Banging on the left-hand side with Bryson Bush on.
Yeah, we get about two yards there.
Second down from the 16-yard line. We trade three receivers to the right-hand side, as well as Mr. Bushon. That's Aliko running the ball there. He avoided a nice loss for a tackle.
There seem to be playing Hardeman everywhere.
Yes, yeah. And wouldn't you?
Yep, I sure would.
Just run him everywhere. They're going to take a timeout, or we're going to take a timeout. Reset, come out of the timeout with three receivers to the left.
Third and about six. We feel like we got a good play call here. We just got to get it up in there and get the first down instead of trying to bounce it.
Yeah, we cut that ball north-south. I think we got a shot at getting the first down. Line up for the field goal, and Alex Flores comes through with a 32-yarder from the left hash.
Good job there by our field goal team. I thought Alex had a tremendous night. You know, he made the two field goals and made extra points when he had to make them.
And the kickoffs.
Yeah, I thought it was great.
Yeah.
That's where we need to kick off, and that's, you know, on the 28-yard line. Great coverage.
Yeah, I'm just tickled to death he went laterally instead of north-south.
Yeah.
Yeah, this offense runs entirely through him. Nice stiff arm.
Well, every time he touches, you know, he obviously gets the ball on every snap. He just holds your breath because he is so athletic and so fast. And he's a lot bigger this year than he was last year.
You're right. This number six, Trey Barnett, I think he might be faster than him. This kid's quick.
Yes, he is. You know, that's the offense runs through those two guys. You know, 21 and 6. And
ooh.
Again, that was a big hit by our linebacker core. Couldn't tell who it was.
Another slobber knocker.
And I think it's short by a couple of inches again, if I'm not mistaken.
You're right. It is. They're going to look at it. And I think this one was actually short by maybe 2 inches, whereas the other one was an inch and a half.
I'm really not surprised that Coach Fritz didn't go for those two just because – you know, we hadn't seen them under center at all. Right. And, you know, your chances of getting a loss in the shotgun formation are greater than when you're under center.
I think the opposing coaches, folks, have seen our front three play, our front, you know, eight, front six, however you want to call it. We get good penetration. We're going to take over first and 10. Good field position now.
Yeah, we got great field position here at the 36-yard line.
Kalen fakes to Alico going to the right, pulls it out and runs hard to the left. We're at the 43-yard line. Second down. Coach, we're getting nice holes.
Yep, good job there on the buck sweep, we call it. We got everybody blocking down, both guards pulling.
Alico told me his shoulders are sore, and I said, this should be the way you lowered your shoulder and hit people. Out to the left-hand side, nice move. I thought Dusty was going to go back inside. He stayed outside.
Good job by Dusty.
I
agree. Dusty played well on both sides of the ball.
Both sides of the ball. We have it there, 43-yard line. Give it to Alico. Look at the holes, coaches.
Again, we're just, you know, we're knocking them off the ball.
Yes.
Doing playing well. We just got to get the ball in the end zone. That's the bottom line.
Kalen pulls it, cuts back to the left-hand side. He's inside the 20-yard line. It's going to be first and 10 at the 19. Double tights, huh?
Yeah, we got double tight in there, and we got our zone called again. Good yardage to about the 13 or 14.
Spread them out a little bit. Three receivers to the right. Fake to Alico going to the right, and they sniffed that one out pretty good.
That was a read play for us, and Kalen made the right read. Just we didn't block it up as well as we wanted to.
We got a little sideline warning against Elbert County. Very few penalties in the game.
Yep, it's third down right here, third and five.
We break a tackle, keep scrambling, and just missed a receiver at the six.
Again, that's two third and fives we just don't make. We got to force field goals. We got to kick a field goal.
From the left hash, from 30 yards out, and Alex Flores puts it down the middle of the goalpost. We lead 6-0. 5 seconds left in the first quarter. We've moved the ball.
Yep, up and down the field.
Another sky kick to the right-hand side, down to the 22.
Another great kick, great coverage. We're inside the 30, which is our goal.
Exactly. So the first quarter comes to close, and we're up 6-0. They had the ball to open the second quarter at the 29-yard line, first and 10. Trying to run a little jet sweep to the right-hand side, and this guy is quick. We finally knock him out of bounds. Roding just a little bit too hard. They're going to tack on a 15-yard penalty at the end of this.
See, I don't know if that should have been a penalty. I mean, it's not a violent tackle.
It's just kind of a continuation of the play. Anyway, they get great field position. We force it back in. Jordan does, and pursuit catches up. They're having a little trouble getting lined up. Look at a couple big guys.
Yeah.
Freshman right guard.
You know, when they came out, you know, for warm-ups, they really don't pass the eye test like Peach did.
Yes, you're right.
But I'm going to tell you, Hardeman's the X factor. You know, when you got somebody like him, that's all you're looking at, really.
Yeah, 78, 92, and 32 do a real good job on that defensive front. They play well. Hardeman fakes the running back going to the left-hand side. He rolls to the right. And
that is Landon Rice. A defensive lineman making a tackle on the sideline.
I have not seen Landon run as fast as he's run as he has the last 2 weeks. He is everywhere. There, look at him stuffing him.
Landon
up.
Again.
Yeah. We could have plays of the game of just number 44, a whole series of them. Got the ball inside the 20-yard line. Fake to the running back, and here goes Hardeman. Spins the leg. And boy, he took
a shot there from Jordan Tao.
And he leaves the game.
Yeah, he leaves the game for a play.
He had a hard time getting up. They had to help him up off the field. He had the wind knocked out of him. Give to the running back. We really make him belly it back. He cuts up, gets inside the 10, down to about the 7-yard line is where we're finally going to stop him.
That was a good call by the referee. Kobe got blocked in the back.
Oh, yes. Backs him up to the 22-yard line where it will be third down. Now they got Hardman back in the game, rolls to the right, and this is what you want him doing, throwing the ball.
Great break by Jordan Tao, almost a pick.
Coach, he baited the quarterback into
throwing it. Yes, he did.
Almost came up with the deflection. Left-footed kicker, David Vera, puts his foot to the ball. It's a 40-yarder, but we have a penalty.
Yeah.
He made that kick.
Yes, he did.
Illegal procedure against him, backs him up five. They're going to put the tee at the 34, makes it a 44-yard field goal kick. We get a big rush. We got a rush specialist in there, Brandon Spector.
Mm-hmm.
And it's short.
Good job by our PAT field goal block team. Put some pressure on him. See, we got a touchdown here. We got Malik wide open. We just can't overthrow him.
Yeah, he had him beat by about 2-3 yards.
We're really, really missing scoring opportunities the more I watch this film, obviously.
Yes.
We run the draw here, and we're lucky there. We put it on the ground, and good job by Kalen getting back on it.
It popped right back to him.
A
fortuitous bounce. Two receivers left, two right. We freeze him at the line of scrimmage. Now, this 32 is a man-child out here on the left-hand side.
Yeah, he really hurt us last year. He was number 82 last year, and it took us about 3 hours to figure out what number he was.
Yeah, he shows up quite a bit. He's a stout young man. We got to dump that ball, don't we?
Yeah, we got to get rid of it.
Yeah,
can't
15
take a
yards.
Sack, you know, inside the 5-yard line.
Yeah, 15-yard sack. Line up Jonah Landry. Got some pressure on him. Punting from his own end zone. Puts his foot into the ball. The best thing about this punt is there's no return.
Yeah, Jonah didn't have as good a night
tonight
as he did last Friday. We got to punt the ball a little better than we did last week for this coming week.
At our 30-yard line, first and 10 for the Blue Devils. They run a sweep to the left-hand side.
Tackle by Rhett.
Yeah, that's what I was referring to earlier. Nice open field tackle.
He makes a one-on-one tackle on Hardeman later in the game. That was
even better.
Yes.
You're right.
I thought that was a block in the back over the
same here.
Edge.
Yeah, the referee did see.
Good black shirt defense there.
The boys are just going to the ball. Lots of gold hats and black shirts. Keeping this guy surrounded, hemmed in. They're at the 27-yard line. Ooh, smacking, but he didn't have the ball. That's okay. Wear him out a little bit. Get the ball at about the 24.5. Line up for a field goal.
And this is even further than the other one.
41-yard field goal. And when he first hit it, I didn't think he was going to make it there. And it just sneaks in on the lower right-hand side.
Yeah, we hadn't seen him kick field goals that distance all year long in the films that we've seen. You know, we didn't think he had that leg in him, but obviously he did.
Yes. 41-yard field goal narrows the deficit to 6-3. They cut it in half.
This is really something we thought we could take advantage of with our kickoff return team, and because he doesn't kick it real deep. But I thought Elbert County's kickoff team did a good job.
We do get a little bit better return later in the game. But, you know, you're starting out at 33, 34 yards.
Mm-hmm.
That's not bad.
Yeah, not bad at all.
You just wanted to take one to the house,
yes.
Weren't you?
Mm-hmm.
We've done that twice this year. Jonah Landry and Baylon Spector. Nice run off the left-hand side. We're getting good blocking, Coach.
That was a great run there, good blocking up front.
Two receivers left and right. Olico behind shotgun Kalen. He's just picking his way and getting downfield, Coach.
Again, we're knocking him off the ball, getting, you know, 5, 6, 7 yards a pop.
Give it to Olico on the right-hand side. He's down to the 35-yard line, keeps the legs churning, and ends up at the 33 or 34. Good line up in the I formation on the right-hand side.
Yeah, we bust that assignment. I don't know what happened between Stout and Landon there. See, they're talking about it.
Exactly, and they let a guy come in pretty much untouched. And this is what happens with Elbert County. We move the ball up and down the field, and they put us behind the chains for a little bit.
We got a screen here. We think it's a first down, and for some reason, the ref wants to call it a fumble, and how he thinks it's a fumble, I have no idea.
He stepped onto the field to mark the ball and then changes his mind because after Jarrett's laying on the ground, and somebody rakes the ball loose like 2 seconds later. That was a really dumb call. This kid is strong.
And then, you know, we're moving the ball up down the field, and we get a bad call, and they got some momentum. So, you know, maybe just one of two passes they completed all night, really.
They throw it out there to Tinch, and we bounce off of him. They've got a nice first down opportunity, and now it's second down after the incomplete pass at our 36. Yeah, the official really went brain dead on that last call. We've got a whistle on the play, a delay of game.
And then they give them a timeout. You know, they don't call the penalty. They give them a timeout.
Exactly. They got
pressure by Landon there and Noah Ferguson. I guess they had a receiver in the area there. I was wanting intentional grounding because in high school you can't just throw it away and throw it in the bleachers like you do in college.
Or pros. Yeah.
Or pros. You got to have somebody in there.
Yeah, there was somebody in the area. I thought Landon Rice did a good job of staying in front of him on that. They throw the ball down the field, and we got good defense on that, Coach.
Yep. Great defense by Malik, and that's where Malik bums his ankle a little bit. You know, he'll be questionable. Maybe we can get him back.
Yeah, we had he came off the field just not putting any pressure on that foot at all. Nice punt. Put him down deep in the territory. They put us down deep inside our 10-yard line. And like I said, you just take a knee, run the clock out. Mm-hmm. Because I think when we got the ball, there was 31 seconds left. We snapped one play, and then we're going to go to halftime with a 6-3 lead. And as you go into halftime, what are you talking to the guys about?
Well, you know, we'll try to make some adjustments offensively, you know, some things that we think will help us in the second half. Defense, we just need to keep doing what we're doing. And, you know, we had to find a way to get in the end zone.
Right.
That's the bottom line. And, you know, we're moving the ball up and down the field. We had the one so-called turnover. We had to settle for two field goals. It should be 14-3 right now instead of 6-3. And, you know, as a coach, you would definitely feel more comfortable if you've got at least a, you know, two-score advantage, you know, with Hardeman touching the ball every play. So a little nervous about the situation being 6-3, but, you know, it is the quarterfinals. It's supposed to be games like that.
Yes, it is. Folks, just sit back there and get you a Daddy-O donut and relax in the Barker Lounger. You're going to see the best doggone band in the land, 284 strong, led by Michael Clark, assisted by Larry Brown, and led on the field by drum major Sarah Green. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show.
Presenting the Calhoun High School marching yellow jackets under the field direction of Miss Sarah Green. Tonight the band will perform Born to be Wild. That's the way I like it. Jazzy beats, Shake It Off, and Mr. Tambourine Band. With soloists Patrick Supers, Ray Gonzalez, Joanna Foley, Austin Cherry, Colin Farrell, Colin Faulkner, Melissa Greason, and Logan Rigney. Ladies and gentlemen, the Calhoun High School Marching Yellow Jackets.
Fieldhouse earlier, or were you here?
Fieldhouse.
How's Malik?
Do you know?
If you went to Fieldhouse, you can see.
Welcome back to the Coach Hal Lamb Show. And Coach, real good halftime performance by the Yellow Jacket Band. We're ready to get started with the second half, trying to find a way to get some six-point plays on the board, aren't we?
Yeah, we get the ball coming out and start the second half, which is, you know, a positive.
Yes.
For sure. So we feel like we need to get down the field and score and make it at least a two-score game.
Take it from the 14-yard line, and Aliko comes straight up the field. He doesn't dance around. He puts his feet in the ground and gets to their 49-yard line. Now, that's a good kickoff return.
We got great, great field position here. I tell you, we got a great play here if Aliko just stays outside. He cuts it up. He sees something. His vision was good last night for sure, but he
exactly.
sees something. So we get about a yard or two.
Fake to Aliko. Throw the ball down the field, and we get a guy wide open. And we can't hold on to the ball.
No, nope, we got 6 points there. We just got to make the catch. That was a great throw by Kalen, and Jarrett would like to have that one back for sure. Now it's third down.
They tipped the ball at the line of scrimmage.
Tipped the ball at the line of scrimmage, so.
I told Jarrett I'm going to get him some Biletnikoff cream.
You know, we got to make some plays when it's there to make. Now we got to punt the football after great field position.
Jonah Landry puts his foot to the ball, kicks it away from Hardman, and the ball rolls around, and Jonah just never got any bounce, any roll to his punts.
To his defense on that one, he's punting into the wind a little
bit there.
I agree.
First and 10. They hand off to the running back, and Coach, our front is just all over them.
You know, it looks like our defense is spread out a little bit, and they are, but I tell you, they're reading their keys, and they're hit by Christian East.
Slobber knocker. 47's pumped. He's smacking a ball carrier and talking a little smack.
Third and long here.
Yes.
Which is where we want them.
Yes, we do.
This might be the big play by Red Abernathy. I mean, it looks like he's great, got great yardage here, and that's a great solo tackle by Red Abernathy.
I was ready to call it a first down on live.
Yeah, forcing a punt to football. We're trying to block this one.
Yes, you are. You're coming after it. And it is a short punt. Put some pressure on him. And fortunately, it doesn't roll.
Yep. We got a, you know, we're at the 50-yard line again, first down.
There you go. We just keep going from 49 to 49 with the start of our possessions in the second half. Give it to Aliko. Pounds on the right-hand side. And huge gain, Coach.
10 yards. I don't know if it's a first down or not.
It is. First and 10 from the 41. Two receivers up top.
And the same play, and that's a read play, and I felt like Kalen might have could have pulled that one.
Yeah, and gone to the as a sweep to the right-hand side. Three receivers right, one to the left. Fake the pass, then he pulls it down and runs, and he's getting his aerobic workout the last two weeks.
That was a good design play we came up with, faking the screen.
And he pulls it down and just runs. Give it to Aliko, cut back in. Keeps the legs churning, gets down to the 25-yard line. It'll be second down and five from the 25. And I guess we missed a block up front.
Yeah, we missed a block up front on the left side. I couldn't tell who it was.
Well, there were three of them tacklers there, so it's going to be a group miss.
Third down here.
We went to throw the ball, pulled it back down, and then we get sacked by number 78 and 92.
Again, we seem to have, you know, three great plays in a row, and then one or two bad plays.
There you go.
You know, we got to be more consistent.
Hey, give Elbert credit. Their defense tight stiffened up once you got down inside the 30. Nice high punt, no return. They're going to take over at their 12-yard line. First and 10. Motion. They fake to the motion man. Hardman keeps it. Nice tackle, coach.
Great job there by who is that? Is that Landon?
Yeah, they got up to, yeah, I believe it was Landon on that one. They got up pretty quick.
He took some hits now. He's I give him credit now. He's a tough sucker, and he's a football player is what he is.
He sticks his nose in there on defense, too.
If somebody's going to get him, he's going to be a great college football player.
Fake the pass.
We almost let him out here.
Yeah. This was. Thank goodness Jordan Tao finally wraps him up with Colby Reynolds.
That's 20 yards there, and we had him tackled probably, you know, a five-yard gain.
Exactly.
There he is again. Again, we're out there on him.
Yeah, that's Noah Ferguson out there helping out with the tackle. Yeah, wide splits with our defense, but we pinched real well. Look at that. Landon Rice coming in from the left defensive end, comes almost over the left guard slot and gets the tackle.
Third and about three, I believe. Again, this is another one of those plays. Nope, this is, we stop him here.
Yes. That's 33. This kid's a load. He's not very tall. He's strong.
Forcing to punt the football again. Great job by our defense.
I thought the wide receiver here was in motion. He's off the line pretty quick.
And then he booms one.
Oh, yeah, and then it stops rolling. Yeah. And it goes out of bounds at the two.
Yeah, that was a tough break for us there. We had Ryan up because he hadn't been punting the ball very well.
Right. He kicks it over our head, and it lays down at the two. Fake to Aliko going to the right. Kalen gets us out from underneath the shadows a little bit farther out. We're at the 6-yard line, second and six after that 4-yard gain. Fake to the right again. Kalen pulls it down, and coach, we got us a first down.
Yeah, got to get a couple first downs and get out from under our own end zone. We got another, I think it's third and one.
Yeah, third and one, I'm sorry.
Yeah, and then we got, we were in motion there, which I thought their backs were in motion all night long, they don't call it.
Right, but they called it on us.
It was a call. We were in motion.
We were.
But let's call it both ways.
I agree. Three receivers to the right.
So it's third down and about six.
Yes.
Big first down play there by Kalen and the offensive lineman. Great blocking up front.
Fake that screen to the right, busted up the middle, and it's still a 6-3 game. We're down to the fourth quarter. Send those three receivers over to the right-hand side. It's first and 10 from our 14 and a half. There's a little reverse action.
Got a little reverse here, and good job by Red Abernathy. And I really, that was a late hit. And I can't believe the guy, you know, to my right didn't call it. I'm trying to get him to call it, and the other guy calls it, which, you know, he was out of bounds.
Well, he's the guy that called the fumble, coach.
Yeah.
He can't see anything. We know that. All right, first and 10. Kalen rolls to the right-hand side. And Colby will tell you he should have caught that. It's going to be a short game.
Good throw there. We just got to make the catch.
Wing to the right-hand side. Kalen fakes the running back to the right, pulls it out, goes to the left, across the 45, and we got a penalty flag coming in late.
They call holding on Landon there. I thought that was a bad call as well. I'll have to go back and look at that.
fortunately, there weren't very many penalties.
There were three on each side, according to the stats.
That's what I had, too. Mm-hmm. That's what Reagan had. Roll to the right-hand side after the penalty. Pull it down. I'm going to scramble a little bit and get up to our 40-yard line. Two receivers left, two right. Aliko to the left is shotgun Kalen. William Long with the snap. Fake to Aliko, drop back. Look downfield, and we're trying to find Ryan Randall, and we just really overthrow him. Some incidental contact.
Yep, he had him beat. For some reason, Ryan stops running about halfway through the route. I don't know if he got hung up with the defender. I couldn't tell. But
there was a little shoving going on. He didn't get a clean break downfield.
We do a good job of getting out of our own end zone, you know, the shadow of our own end zone.
Does it scare you?
Yes. Coach Stevenson's hollering from the sideline, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And lo and behold, Hardman picks it up.
But he only gets 5 yards, yep. Thank goodness. Now they start gashing us a little bit. They find a little bit of a running game right now.
Yep. Again, you know, we're shooting ourselves in the foot offensively.
Yes. We had opportunities to score, yep. Score points, Coach.
We've had tremendous opportunities to score points after watching the tape.
Give to the running back on the right-hand side, and like I said,
again, they got a first down by a foot, it looks like.
Yeah, that was a short first down make. They're at our 49-yard line. Hardman, slow him down, knock him out of bounds, and we finally cannot catch up with him. He goes 50 yards.
That's really the only play he got out, and it was a busted play, really. He fakes. He's supposed to run this way, and he just goes the other way. And you know, with 9 minutes to go in the game, they got a lead.
That's what I said on the radio. I thought that play was designed to come back to the right. Mm-hmm. But his vision, he takes it to the left-hand side, and they get a touchdown. They had the lead, 10-6. It's a little bit over 9 minutes left, and Mr. Vera is going to put his left foot to the ball.
We've got an answer, you know, for sure.
From the 10-yard line, coming across the field, Bushong does. Puts his shoulder down, crosses the 30, and gets it up near the 35-yard line.
Got good field position here at the 35-yard line.
First and 10, 9:09 left. We trail 10-6. Aliko finding some nice holes.
Gets 5 yards.
Robbie's Raiders are fired up.
Yeah, we got Noah Davenport in there some here at left guard to give us a little more beef in there. Good run by Kalen here. Gets it down to the plus 35.
Yeah, it's going to be first and 10. That was a big run. Once again, we've got some offense going here. Here's a nice play. Get another 5 or 6 yards. Aliko Dennis running the ball. We've got it at their 29-yard line. Fake to Aliko on the right-hand side. Kalen keeps it. He falls forward. He gains 2 yards, and now we're down to the 24.
First down?
Yes, sir. We freeze him at the line of scrimmage. No, Elbert called a timeout. Now we're back ready. We got a cluster of guys in there, Coach.
Run a quarterback power in there for about 3 yards.
Yeah, we'll take that. He run 4 3-yard plays and got a first down. We got two offensive linemen out here standing in front of our two receivers on the right-hand side.
Yep, we got Jack out there trying to get a little, you know, Jonah's eligible down here. And I tell you, it scared us to death before snap because Hardeman sees it.
Yes,
and
he does.
Hardeman's football smart. He saw it out there, and he's trying to tell everybody. But great throw by Kalen.
And the ball just seemed to take forever to get there.
Great catch by Jonah.
And then we convert.
Get a first, I thought Jonah scored, to be honest with you, but, you know, we'll take it. We'll get it on the inch line, and Kalen scores, and we go ahead.
I was pretty sure the sumo set could shove Kalen into the end zone. We line up for the extra point. Alex Flores having a good night kicking. Jacob Callahan snapping. Jared Carden holding. It's through the upright, and we lead 13-10.
That was a great answer. You know, we're down with 9 minutes to go. Now we're leading with 6 minutes to go.
Now the sky kick, this one by Gabriel Garcia.
Actually,
only this is a squib kick back to the left.
Yeah, it was a good kick. If we get it by 27, you know, and 23 picks it up.
Coach, he's blowing a whistle, and the kid hasn't recovered it. He's holding it against his bum. They do get the ball, but I just thought they blew the whistle too quick. They run a running play to the left-hand side. Yeah, I was told beforehand that Gabriel comes in, we're going to squib it.
Mm-hmm.
So I waited until he actually kicked it to call it.
Yeah.
Bang on the left-hand side. Oh, I was glad they didn't throw a flag there.
Third and two?
Yes. From there, 41, 42-yard line. They do get the first down, but not by a whole lot. We've got him hemmed in.
Yeah, they gave him a spot all the way to the line, and I didn't think he got that far. And I asked that referee, I said, you sure he got to the line?
Yeah, I didn't think he made it to the
45-yard
line. Banging over right guard, falls forward, gets a 2-yard gain. It's going to be second and 8. Three receivers up left. They went to this three-receiver formation a lot here late in the game. To midfield. Ball's going to be spotted right at the 50. It's going to be third down. And about 5. Long 4.
Great job by Jordan Tao.
Nice tackle for a loss.
Yep. Great defense.
I think Elbert County found out that this Calhoun team got a pretty good amount of speed all over the field.
You know, there was very little, you know, they didn't even sniff a turnover.
No.
You know, the ball didn't come loose at all.
No.
They didn't turn the ball over, and we supposedly turned it over once, but shouldn't have been called, but it was.
Yeah, we throw that one pass at the end of the game, it really doesn't count. And
well, here we go with 3 minutes to go. We feel like we got to get 2 first downs and the game's over. And I think Elbert, I think they got 2 timeouts left, I think.
2, yes, sir.
So we get good yardage on first down. Second down, they call it. Third down, they call timeout. And I really like the play call here. You know, we told Kalen if it's not there to run it. And I really thought that was a horse collar.
Well, he did grab him by the back of the shoulder pads. They didn't call it. Of course, the guy on our side, he can't see anything anyway, so he goes out and talks to the referee, and they're not going to call it.
No.
At this point in time, you're wasting your breath.
Yeah, I thought 82 made a good play there. I thought we had a good play call, and they covered it up pretty good.
Now we get a good roll.
We get a decent roll here.
Yep. Nose of the ball turned over, and we push them back to their 41-yard line. There is a minute 52 left.
Minute 52, they've got 0 timeouts, so, you know, we're feeling good about it if we don't let him loose.
Exactly.
I can't explain this play. I really can't. I mean, I thought everybody stopped. I thought, you know, there was a motion penalty. I don't know if that was by design. I don't have to look at it.
I think it was a design play where everybody comes to a stop. The receiver just streaks downfield, and it worked. They complete the pass. They've got a first and 10 at our 25. Hardman scrambles to the left-hand side. You didn't hear any whistles on the field on the previous play, did you?
Mm-hmm.
I think it was a design play, a little trick play. Empty backfield, motion from left to right. Give to the motion man on the jet sweep. Do a good job of hemming him in.
Yep.
He gets positive yards.
You can see the clock, minute 16. They don't have any timeouts.
Nope.
And I'm thinking about, you know, using timeouts to at least have the ball with, you know, with some time left.
They're down to the 6-yard line. Motion.
I thought this was a tremendous goal line stand by our defense.
A very good goal line stand. It's to the 5.5. Running back to the right. Gives it to the running back. He wants to get outside. There's no place to go. We make him belly back and we hit him.
Good job.
Loss on the play, Coach.
Yep.
That pushes him back to the 7-yard line, or 8-yard line.
Forces a field goal here. We call timeout to ice him a little bit.
They're at the 8, spot the tee at the 15. It's going to be a 25-yard field goal, and I'm hoping this guy shanks his puppy. He gets it up.
He about shanks it, but he hits a line drive through.
It was a knuckleball.
Yep.
It was ugly, but it went through. 13-13 with 40 seconds left.
But I really pleased with the goal line stand, though. Great job by our defense.
Defense played well. just played great the whole night, Coach.
So we got 40 seconds left and two timeouts. So I'm thinking, okay, give us a good kickoff return, give us a chance to get down and kick a field goal to win the game. And
we bring it out to the 36, 37-yard line, first and 10. We have the wind, a gentle breeze at our back.
Mm-hmm.
Roll to the left-hand side. Nice down and out here.
Good job by Ryan getting out of bounds. We got it at midfield.
First and 10. Two receivers up top, two at the bottom. Roll to the right.
Run the other way and just overthrow it a little bit. That's, you know, that's fine. Incomplete pass stops the clock.
Yeah, right. That's the big thing. Stop the clock. It was going to be a minimal game to begin with. Looking downfield. We try to find Balin on a streak down the left-hand side, but he's just not as speedy as he used to be.
No, he's not 100%, that's for sure.
Two receivers right, two left. A little down and out here.
Good job by Dusty getting out of bounds. I think there's 9 seconds to go.
Correct.
We got a chance to... I don't know what happened here.
Well, he got sacked. His arm got hit as he threw the ball. Got tipped.
And then when he catches it, you know, you're holding your breath.
Make sure that we get him knocked out of bounds. And the clock's going to expire, so we're going to go to the first overtime. Took a long time for the officials to explain the rules to you.
Well, you know, it was different from last week. You know, they said we get a 3-minute break, which I was glad. And then they talked to us about the overtime. And then they bring the players out, you know. Last week, you know, the coaches flipped the coin.
Exactly.
And I said something to the referee about that. I said, last week we coaches flipped it. He said, well, by rule, you're not supposed to do that. I said, okay.
Everybody reads that rule book different, I guess.
Yeah.
All right, so Kalen Riley's out there with Hardman. And folks, pay attention after the coin toss and after the referees make the decision. Watch these two guys come together. A lot of mutual respect out there. I didn't see a whole lot of yapping in this game. I thought it was pretty clean.
No, I think it was a lot of respect from each other. And, you know, I have a lot of respect for Coach Fritz.
Yes, you did.
I thought he had a great plan. He's a great person. And good job by Jaira Wilson. Gets him behind the sticks early.
We go on defense first. We won the toss. It puts him first and 15 from the 20.
Yeah, I don't know what happened here.
We just got bounced.
It looked like Jaira just fell down.
Bounced outside, and I didn't see exactly.
It was second and 15, and they got 13, I thought that was a big play. So
huge. Third and short. They bang up in there.
Again, it's hard to tell if he got a first down or not, but they gave it to him.
Yeah, from our angle. So it's going to be first and goal from the 5. We're in the first overtime. Good job of stuffing him after a 1-yard gain. Second and goal from the 4. Two receivers out here to the right. And they really, as the quarterback bangs over the right-hand side, they really took to having big splits with their offensive line in overtime. They were really trying to move us around.
Third down, great defense. Third and 1, and I don't know what happened to the ball, but somehow 78 ended up with it.
And he's standing in the back of the end zone to hold the ball up.
So it's fourth down.
Yes, it is. And he's going to go for it, a half yard away. And he jumps a la Herschel Walker, lays the ball, breaks the plane of the goal line as he lays the ball across the goal line, and that's going to be a touchdown, I guess.
I wish we had some goal line cameras.
Same here. They line up, kick the extra point, and they lead 20-13, and we get our chance with the ball from the 15.
Yep, we got to answer for sure. We got to get a touchdown and an extra point to send it into another one.
Two receivers to the right, one to the left. Fake to Aliko, give it to Kalen. He gets down inside the 10-yard line.
Good yards on first down. We got 6 yards.
Second and 4. Eye formation with 3 receivers to the right, 1 to the left. Kalen underneath center. William Long with the snap. Give to Aliko. Didn't get much. Got back to the line of scrimmage. That was about it.
Yep. That was. We had a little trap play in there. Didn't work.
Yep. Give them credit.
Yep.
Now we line up in a heavy formation. Fake to Aliko, and Kalen's got us a first down inside the 5. First and goal from the 4 in that heavy formation again. And Kalen just keeps power driving and goes into the end zone.
Good answer by the offense there. I think Elbert calls timeout here to ice the kicker.
Yeah, they did. Yeah, they did call timeout. Everybody gets a timeout per overtime period, right?
Yep.
Don't get to carry him from the game. Good snap from Jacob. Good hold by Jarrett. They come hard, and Alex kicks it through the upright. Goes to the tie ball game 20-20, and we go immediately back to offense.
Yeah, that was a great, kick by Alex. I thought he was, good snap, good hold. Because you worry about things like that in pressure situations, to be honest, because we hadn't been under pressure as a field goal team yet.
Ask my darling bride about worry. She was sitting at home pacing around the radio. Loss on that first play. We didn't get off to a good start, so it's going to be second down from the 17. Scramble to the right-hand side, back to the left. Now we got an opening. Kalen gets inside the 10. He's at the 5, and he's going to get into the end zone on a nice read by Kalen. Trying to throw the ball to the right, scrambles back to the left.
That was a great job by Kalen. It wasn't much there, and no. I thought he did a great job.
Well, speaking of pressure on extra points, here we go again. Jacob Callahan snapping, Jared Cardin holding. And Alex Flores doing the kicking. They didn't rush that hard that time.
No,
you notice that? We lead 27-20. Now we go to defense. They get the ball at the 15. Snap to the quarterback. Give the running back on the right-hand side. Minimal gain of about 2 yards there. Going to be second and 8 from the 13.
As a coach, you feel pretty good in this situation.
Yes,
you got a touchdown lead, and your defense is playing well. If we could just hold them out of the end zone.
But then they've got number 21. But we're doing a good job. Look at all the gold hats around the ball, Coach.
So it's 3rd and 6 here, I believe.
From the 12-yard line. Running back to the left. Quarterback rolls to the left, goes in, wants to go outside, cuts back in, and he gets it down to the 7-yard line where it's going to be 4th down, Coach.
4th and 2, maybe?
Yes, sir.
And it looked like we had him for a loss back there, and he somehow gets out of it.
Somehow.
Run the quarterback sweep, and we almost had him.
Almost, yeah. And they came in running in from both sides. Both the officials, side judges, are on the 5-yard line, so that means it's going to be a 1st down.
I can't remember how many times it was spotted right on the line or 3 inches from the first down. It was like that all night long.
Exactly. 2nd down from the 4. Yeah, I think they guessed a lot. They like to mark quick and then change. And then Hardman gets down near the goal line, and he gets enough impetus, and he falls into the end zone. He has a touchdown, and now they have to kick the extra point to tie it up.
Mm-hmm. Again, he missed an extra point last week, so we're – I'm hoping that he hooks it, but he doesn't. He knocks it through.
I'm talking shank up there underneath my breath, Coach. I'm going shank, shank, shank. 27-27. They go right back on offense from the 15. 27-27 ball game, 3rd overtime period. Fake to the running back, quarterback keeps and goes over right tackle, gets 3 yards down to the 12. Guys are starting to get tired right now, aren't they?
Yes, they are. I think both teams are tired.
Yes, both teams.
I was a little bit surprised Coach Fritz didn't go for a 2-point conversion a while ago. We were thinking that he might, but obviously he felt like he wanted to get to another overtime.
And he felt like his boy's going to get him a touchdown.
Yep.
We stuffing him at the 11. It's going to be
4th down.
Yeah, 4th down from the 11. Great defensive stand. They're going to line up for the field goal. It's going to be a 27-yarder. Left footer puts his foot in the ball and gets a little bit better kick this time. They lead 30-27. Great defensive stand again.
Great defense. And all we got to do is score a touchdown, and we're victorious.
You can say that now when you say all we got to do is score a touchdown.
All
right, we start things off, and pretty much I thought this was going to be the Calhoun Riley show, that he was going to get the ball on every snap and run it.
Yep, we got 5 yards there, or at least 4.
2nd down from the 11. 2 receivers left. Give it to Olico. He puts his shoulder down. Gets inside the 10-yard line. They're going to spot it at the 8. 3rd and goal. We're in our heavy formation to the right. Kalen keeps it. Follows the boys. Keeps a leg drive. Keeps pushing. And powers into the end zone for his 4th touchdown of the night. And a 33-30 victory. Triple overtime victory for the Yellow Jackets, Coach.
That was a great run by Kalen there. Good blocking up front.
Yes.
3rd and 3.
3rd and 3.
And he got, 12 or 13?
Well, that was an 8-yard run for the touchdown
there.
But, you want to make it 12? I'll make it 12. It's a winning touchdown.
Yep.
So 2 weeks in a row, you've got this overtime thing figured out on a full moon night, by the way. You win once in overtime at the north end. You win once in the south end. Unfortunately, we're not going to be back at the Reeve next week.
Yeah, I was surprised that Elbert chose that end of the field, to be honest with you. You know, that's where we wanted it to be, with the Jumbotron loud and
the horn.
Yeah, and the horn. So, you know, it was really, really surprised that they chose that. But, you know, it was a great win. And, you know, this time of year, like we said last week, survive in advance. And we've done that the last 2 weeks for sure.
You've really survived by the whiskers on your chinny chin chin. We're going to take a timeout. We're going to come back and look at the Stingers, the plays of the game. You're watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show. Welcome back, Yellow Jacket football fans. And Coach, we're going to go to the plays of the game, the Stingers, and we have a lot to pick from. And I think the first one might be a defensive stop by.
First play of the game.
Yeah.
Pat Landon set the tone. The first play of the game defensively. Good job by Landon. And we got the tackle eligible play. We slide Jonah in the game, and Hardeman sees it. I mean, we had shown it, but Hardeman sees a lineman out there. We got Jack lined up. I really thought Jonah got in the end zone. I mean, I don't know how he spots that where he did, but we'll get it in the end zone.
That's our buddy from our sideline. No comment. Nice tackle by Jordan Tao on
a big third down play and forced him to punt the football.
Exactly.
In the fourth quarter.
Yeah, number 10 stepped up and did it big time. We're in overtime. Nice job by Jairo Wilson. Shoestring tackle on Mr. Hardman.
Great play by Jairo there. Jairo one-on-one tackle. You know, the best athlete in the nation, they say.
Yeah, he's good.
I agree.
Roll to the right-hand side. Here comes a big scramble, and Kalen uses his vision. Nice blocking downfield, and he goes in pretty much untouched for a touchdown in the second OT.
That was a great scramble by Kalen. I thought our linemen, when they saw he scramble, I thought they did a good job blocking.
Line up in our heavy formation. We're in the third overtime. Kalen breaks the tackle, keeps the legs turning, follows Robbie's Raiders and into the end zone for the game-clinching touchdown, and 100 Yellow Jackets storm onto the field to celebrate.
Yep, that was a good win.
Yeah.
Good win.
Yeah, that was a real good win.
Yep.
You can grin big time, all right? It was a great, great win. As we move on to the final four, to the semifinals, and we are going to be taking on Blessed Trinity at Blessed Trinity. And I'm thinking this is the two best teams in the state, Coach.
Well, you know, when the brackets came out, you know, we always, you know, get an early peek at them. And, you know, our coaching staff felt like this was the way it would happen. Of course, I think our road has been tougher than their road for sure. But we felt like we'd be playing Blessed Trinity in the semis because, you know, coming into the season, everybody projected them to be number two and us to be number one in the rankings. And they're a very good football team. They're very well coached. You know, they are a good football team. I hadn't seen any tape on them yet, but, you know, I've talked to a couple of people, and they're battling the injury bug as well as we are. So,
yes. It's,
you know, we're going to – both teams will have to piece together a football team. But it'll be a great football game. It'll be two great teams going at it. I think Coach McFarland, who's I know fairly well, he's a very good football coach. He'll have his team ready. We hadn't played them. You know, I don't think we've ever played them.
Right. You know, not in football, at least.
They'll be Quad A next year, and we'll be Triple A. So this may be the only time we play them. But you know, it'll be a. You know, I have no idea what their facilities are like. Hadn't been there, but I'll call and find out. You know what the situation is, and it's the semifinals. You're supposed to play good teams, and. We'll go down there and see what happens.
The field is 100 yards long with 10-yard end zones at each end. And the way our guys are playing right now, they know they can win. These last 2 weeks, a single overtime victory last week, double overtime victory last week, wasn't it? Single overtime victory last week. Triple overtime. There's so many of these overtimes that get confused. Triple overtime here. The guys just have that confidence that when it's tight, when we need a play, they make the plays. I don't think they really care where they play. Yes, they would rather play at Phil Reeves Stadium, but let's go buckle up to chin straps. Let's play ball.
Yeah, you know, it came down to a coin flip, which, you know, that's the way the state sets it up, and we lost it. You know, it is turf. I do know that Blessed Trinity has turf, so it'll be, you know, like you said, it's the same length and width. And
oh, yeah.
Go down there and play and see what happens. But I feel good about our football team. I think we're playing well. We just got to get, you know, we got to find a way to get the ball in the end zone and the red zone. So we'll go down there and see what happens.
We'll get the MASH unit hooked up. We'll get these guys healed with Joe Ogden, our trainer, and Dr. Mitch Fricks. We'll get everything going. Folks, if you'd like to watch the Boys of Fall many, many times, just go to CalhounTDClub.com. That's CalhounTDClub.com. And a shout out to Coach Bill Long's video broadcasting class, and in particular to our director, Louis Reyes, our producer, Phoebe Jude, and our audio engineer, Sam Magnacherry. Coach, they came in on Thanksgiving weekend. They could be doing anything else. These three young people, they're veterans. They're here. They did a nice job. They keep me in line and keep us make a nice production. So congratulations to all of them.
Yeah, that appreciate you guys. Thanks for coming in on this Thanksgiving weekend.
Coach Long can come in here and do the cameras and let those three run the production board, and they do an outstanding job. Outstanding. Hey, congratulations again. 33-30, triple overtime victory. Let's go take on those Titans.
Sounds good.
You've been watching the Coach Hal Lamb Show.